As you probably know, exoplanets can be pretty weird places. Some of them have atmospheres that are torch black or rain made out of molten glass. But do their names have to be so weird too? I mean, they have names like HD20504b and Kepler-12c. Why can't they be named after cool stuff like Supreme Court justices or members of the Wu-Tang Clan? First of all, there are thousands of exoplanets, so coming up with good names for every single one of them would take a really long time. But more importantly, these names give astronomers really valuable information about each planet. And when you've got thousands of them to sort through, that's pretty helpful. A planet name like Ghostface would be cool, but it doesn't tell you a whole lot. One of the most common exoplanet names is the letters HD and then a whole string of numbers and then a lowercase letter. The HD and the number are actually the name of the star that the planet orbits. Astronomers have massive databases of stars and each one gets a number, so the HD part helps them look up the star's location. The letter at the end tells you in what order the planet was discovered. So the first one gets a B and then a C and then on down the alphabet. When a bunch of exoplanets orbiting the same star are discovered all at once, they'll usually be ordered based on their distance from that star. So the closest one will get a B and then the next one out C and so on. Now if later on astronomers find a new planet orbiting the same star, it will get the next unused letter, regardless of where it orbits. Now you might be wondering, why did the planet start with the letter B? That's because astronomers use a capital A to indicate the star in a solar system, or the brightest star if there's more than one. So in a binary system, the brighter star would get a capital A, the dimmer star would get a capital B, and the first planet would get a lowercase b. Sometimes stars with exoplanets will be named after the mission or the project that discovers them. So planets found by the Kepler mission will start with the word Kepler, and planets that were found by the Corot mission will start with the word Corot. There's been a lot of talk in the scientific community about trying to give exoplanets more interesting names, and it's likely that in the future, some of the coolest discoveries, say if we find an exoplanet that we know to be a lot like Earth, those will finally get names that are easier to remember. That's it for this Q&Alien. Keep an eye on PlanetQuest for the next video in the series and all the news and images you can handle, because exoplanet science never stops.